y'all, welcome back to Monique St. Pierre Fitness, where today I'm so very excited to be presenting y'all with this video. I'm going to be taking you, yes you, into my hot yoga class today. So I've been getting a lot of different questions from people that they want to do for adventures is what to expect from their first hot yoga experience. I know this has become a very popular workout trend, you know, anything that you want to call it, but the fact is that it works, okay? So what we're going to be going to today, it's a hot yoga class at Cocoa Beach Hot Yoga, and what this is focusing on is the Bikram style. So it's going to be 26 postures, 2 breathing exercises, 90 minutes, which is going to be the same every time you go through because it's a practice, and so you're always practicing these postures and these breathing activities and always trying to challenge yourself to get better at it. And what's great is that each time you can kind of see your progression on how you go throughout your journey with your yoga practice. So what I'm going to be showing y'all is what to expect, and then also the fun aspects of it. We'll do kind of a little questionnaire with the owner and the teacher of the practice, Will, and then I'll tell y'all what to put in your bag, and we'll just see what else I find out along the way, guys, all right? So join me in this trip. I hope this is what y'all wanted. Remember, you can always let me know what type of classes, fitness trends, races, adventures y'all want to try out. I'll do them for you and kind of report back to you on how it is. It's not scary that first time you go out there. All right, guys, get out there and experience the world. Love it, live it, and you'll feel happier and healthier and glad that you did. Love it. All right, so I think one of the most important things before you go to a hot yoga class for your first time is to feel comfortable going. So what that means is, what am I wearing? What am I bringing? What can I expect? You know, what is going to prepare me the best to feel comfortable. My personal experience, what made the huge difference for my first time going to yoga, is feeling comfortable in my own skin, kind of knowing what to expect so you weren't uncomfortable. Because let's be honest, 90 minutes is a freaking long time in today's society, okay? Especially if you're in one place, especially if you're all over the place like me. So knowing what to do so that I was comfortable is kind of what I've been practicing, so I feel the best. So number one thing for me was clothing. So what I found, I usually like wearing capris, but with the capris, you know, you're hot, you're sweaty, you're in 105 degree temperature, and I was always like pulling on them and not really practicing on my postures and paying attention to my body. I was more worried about my clothing. So make sure you wear something that's very breathable. It's going to be really hot. You're literally going to be drenching sweat. People say that all the time. This class, you literally are, okay? So make sure it's breathable. I usually wear like a cotton tank and take it off if, you know, I get too hot. And I like these shorts. They're really flexible. They kind of move up and down. I don't have to worry about them. Don't wear shorts that are too tight that you're going to be pulling on during all your sessions, okay? It's not cute. And also, it kind of distracts you and the rest of your class around for it. Another thing is, anybody with long hair, it's really important to figure out which hairstyle is going to be the best for you in your practice so it stays back and you're not messing with your hair. I usually wear my hair right on top of my head. However, in different postures that we go through in this class, you'll see that that kind of inhibits your growth and your flexibility, where your forehead has to be on the mat and it can't get there because your giant bun's in the way. Or if you even wear it kind of down at the bottom of your neck, it interferes a lot with really getting your neck back. So make sure it's kind of comfortable. What's worked best for me, my hair is about yay long. So what's really worked for me is just putting it back in a normal French braid, all right? So that kind of keeps it out of the way. Just kind of experiment with what's best for you. That's what I did, all right? And you'll figure all that out. Next, we'll be moving into what you should put in your bag, all right? So I do have a pretty hefty gym bag. Most importantly, is going to be your water, okay? Super important to stay hydrated during this class. You're sweating out, purifying, detoxing your body for 90 minutes, okay? So you want to make sure that you're replenishing. The Bikram yoga is really, really disciplined in when you take your breaks and when you take your water breaks. So it's going to kind of pace you so you know what to expect. So just listen to your instructor in your class, and he or she will kind of aid you in when to take water breaks. So let's go in his bag. Also, you'll want your yoga mat, obviously. Some studios might provide them, but please bring your own, guys, okay? You're sweating like nobody else's business in here. So just for hygiene, and everyone cleans their mats, bring your own, have your own sweaty body fluids on your own mat, okay? Safety first. Then what you'll need is actually a beach towel or one of the yoga mats that go on top of the yoga mats towels. What this is going to do is kind of aid in not letting the surface be too slippery, okay? Because you're going to sweat, you're going to slip, and that can set you up for injuries. So it's really stabilizing your surface in the back. And then you'll also want a little sweat towel for the class so you can kind of sweat off. I tend to get sweat in my eyes. I've sweated so much, even in some of the inversion-like postures, I've gotten water up in my nose. It felt like I was, you know, water up in the nose when you're swimming. So bring your towel off. And then make sure you have another towel clean for after class, okay? Lots of studios will have showers that you can jump in and shower off because you really are going to get gross, but it's going to be beautiful. Deal? Put those babies away. Alrighty, and then if you want to get ready after class, again, they have a lot of those showers, so. Once that's all done, zipped up and ready to go, I believe we're on our way, guys. Let's go.
I mean, I've yoga, but not the hot yoga. And being that we live in Florida, I was like, do I just do outside yoga? But being in the 104 degree heat and the humidity really adds so much to yes. the yoga, and you get so much more benefit out of all of the postures. So I really, really enjoyed that.
Beautiful, beautiful. So did you know anything about hot yoga before you came the first time?
I'd heard about it, thought people were crazy,
right?
But, you know, get into it.
Good, good. So what's your least favorite thing so far?
Just be how dehydrated you get, which yes. is also a benefit because you're sweating out the toxins, but you're very thirsty afterwards. You have to constantly hydrate all day, all night, you know, to really get through this class.
So bring your water bottle, kids.
Yes. Hydrate or die.
What is your most favorite thing about hot yoga so far?
My favorite thing is how much improvement you see so quickly. You know, this is my fifth class, and I'm already noticing my back is stronger, my legs are stronger. Breathing is better, especially in Florida, this heat that we deal with. Really, just every single day makes a difference.
Okay. A newbie coming to hot yoga, what would your advice be to them?
The
but they just were like, I want to come.
My best advice would be to stick with it. Your first class is the hardest. You're going to be sore. You're going to be tired. But honestly, stick with it and you will see the benefits. You will love it. 2, 3, 4 times in, you'll never give it up.
Great. Wonderful.